one of the best open source models available today. I separated my test question into 5 categories with evaluation criteria for each test category. DeepSeek V3 failed in this test. Provided game instruction as I wanted. Let's try this game. I wasn't expecting such a long answer for this challenge. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm breaking down everything you need to know about DeepSeek V3-0324. We'll cover what's new, how it performs on key benchmarks, and most importantly, I'll run real-world tests to see if it actually lives up to the hype. Stick around, because the results might surprise you. Let's get started. DeepSeek just dropped a brand new model, DeepSeek V3-0324. If you've been keeping up with AI, you've probably heard whispers about DeepSeek, a rising force in open source AI. But if you haven't, you're lucky you're watching this video, because I'm about to break it all down for you and run real-world tests. Believe me, you really need to see these wild results. It's definitely going to be fun. DeepSeek isn't just another AI company. They're building high-performance models designed for coding, reasoning, and real-world tasks. But here's what really sets them apart. Unlike closed-source giants like OpenAI's GPT series, DeepSeek is fully transparent and widely accessible. And they don't just talk about open source, they live it. Their latest model, DeepSeek V3-0324, is released under the MIT license, one of the most permissive open-source licenses out there. What does that mean? It means anyone can use, modify, and even commercialize this model without restrictions. This is a huge deal. While other AI models often come with strings attached, like restrictive commercial policies or required attributions, DeepSeek is making AI truly open and accessible for developers, researchers, and even businesses. And this commitment to open source isn't new for them. In fact, they recently hosted an incredible open source event, and I covered each day in detail. If you want the full breakdown, check the video link in the description, you don't want to miss that one. But today? It's all about their biggest leap yet, DeepSeek V3-0324. Let's start with some initial reactions from social media. Some people are hyped, some are skeptical, and there's already a heated discussion happening. Jen Zhu congrats the DeepSeek team by saying, "Did DeepSeek RE just drop a around 700 GB MIT-licensed model without making a big deal about it? This team is incredible. They are too young to be this smart and wise at the same time. And here there are 2 important points Tior Taxis emphasizes while replying to Jen Zhu's post. 2 underappreciated improvements. 1. Custom license on V3 the original. 2. Some time ago, DeepSeek has added the option to opt out of training on your data. I'll leave it on for general use, of course. Gotta give back something. Previously, we already talked about the importance of MIT mentioned in item 1, so I want you to pay more attention to the second item. This is a big deal for user privacy and data control. Previously, when you use DeepSeek's API or tools, your interactions might have been used for training future models. Now, users can choose to opt out, meaning their data won't be used for improving the model. The opt-out option is a step toward greater user trust and ethical AI development, balancing improvement versus privacy concerns here. I hope I made things clear here for you. Here's another post I picked for you guys. Paul Gauthier says, DeepSeek's new V3 scored 55% on Ada's polyglot benchmark, significantly improving over the prior version. It's the number 2 non-thinking reasoning model, behind only Sonnet 3.7. V3 is competitive with thinking models like R1 and 3 Mini. Paul mentioned about Ada's polyglot benchmark, which is a coding-focused benchmark that tests AI models on their ability to generate, understand, and modify code across multiple programming languages. It also considers cost efficiency, comparing models based on their performance per dollar spent. I want you to pay more attention to the fact that DeepSeek V3-0324 has improved coding performance significantly over its previous version. Secondly, this new model V3 is highly competitive with reasoning-focused models, showing it has solid general-purpose capabilities, even if it's not explicitly optimized for reasoning tasks. It's still behind Claude 3.7 Sonnet, but it's one of the best open-source models available today. Alright, before we jump into my test cases, I want to share a classic example of how AI models improve over time. This example from Tior Taxis perfectly illustrates the evolution of AI reasoning. When you see this, you'll understand why DeepSeek's growth is so important not just for this model, but for the entire future of AI. O3 beats DeepSeek first, but check the evolution of DeepSeek by time. As we understand from all posts in X, it is not hard to tell that this update crushes benchmarks in coding, math problem solving, and expert-level reasoning. It's trained on a broader dataset with optimized techniques, pushing its capabilities beyond anything we've seen from DeepSeek before. Let's jump on benchmarks real quick.
Let's start with MMLU Pro. If you've never heard of it, it's one of the best ways to measure how well an AI understands broad, general knowledge. Think of it as the AI equivalent of an advanced university test across multiple subjects. DeepSeek went from 75.9 to 81.2, a pretty solid jump. Then there's GPQA. This one is all about graduate-level professional qualification assessments, a fancy way of saying, can this AI think like a domain expert? The score here jumped by 9.3 points, meaning this model isn't just memorizing data, it's getting better at reasoning through professional-level problems. And then we have AIME and Live Codebench, which get really interesting. AIME measures an AI's ability to handle advanced math and engineering challenges. DeepSeek's score here skyrocketed by nearly 20 points, which is borderline unheard of in a single model update. And Live Codebench is the one that tests real-world coding performance, and we're seeing a huge leap in capabilities. That's a strong sign that DeepSeek is becoming a serious contender for developers. Additionally, DeepSeek mentioned a few more points. For instance, they improved the executability of the code in front-end development so it creates more aesthetically pleasing web pages and game front-ends. There are also improvements in Chinese writing proficiency and search capabilities. Lastly, we see that they fixed function calling issues from previous V3 versions. But let's be real, benchmarks don't tell the whole story. The real question is, how does DeepSeek V3 actually perform when put to the test?
So, I prepared some challenging prompts to find out how DeepSeek V3 will handle them. For this test, we can either use DeepSeek's own platform or OpenRouter. I prefer to use OpenRouter since I came across a service not available from time to time in DeepSeek's own platform, which is one thing to improve, I believe. Anyway, I separated my test question into 5 categories with evaluation criteria for each test category. First one is general language understanding evaluation. I'm aiming to assess an AI model's ability to handle more complex linguistic challenges and demonstrate deeper language comprehension with sentiment analysis. Let's send this prompt to DeepSeek V3 and see the result. Cool. It made a good analysis to detect nuanced sentiments. Let's mark this test as passed. Second category is massive multitask language understanding. I want to assess the model's breadth of knowledge and reasoning capabilities across different domains. Let's test prompt number 2. Amazing! It just gave us short approaches for each, exactly as we described in the prompt. DeepSeek V30324 is passing from this challenge as well. Third category is reasoning and problem-solving benchmarks. Here, the goal is to evaluate the model's capacity to solve complex mathematical problems and handle multi-step mathematical challenges. Let's see how DeepSeek V3 handles this math challenge. It provides the result with 3 detailed steps, and the result looks correct. DeepSeek V3 passes this challenge too. Fourth category is specialized domain benchmarks. The purpose of my test here is to assess models' specialized benchmarks in scientific and medical domains. This challenge is a bit long, but let's see how it will handle this. Alright, I see that DeepSeek stuck to our prompt and provided us with a very detailed result with sections. It is a pretty long answer, and that shows knowledge of specialized domains. DeepSeek deserved another pass here. And the last category is ethical AI and bias testing. I want to assess the model's ability to identify and mitigate potential biases, respond ethically to challenging scenarios, and demonstrate fairness and neutrality. This challenge is a bit long, but let's see how it will handle this. To be honest, I wasn't expecting such a long answer for this challenge. DeepSeek provided the answer not only from law, but also from passenger perspective as well. DeepSeek is definitely passing this test. Additionally, I added two more tests and want to try them. In this prompt, I want DeepSeek to write a poem where the second letter of each word when put together spells code. I see that it took each second word in each row, not each second letter in words. Unfortunately, DeepSeek V3 failed in this test. Alright, the last but the fun one. I saw that many people tried to create a game with one prompt with multiple models. Let's see, DeepSeek V3 can also create a game with 3JS. It takes a bit of time to code it, so I will fast forward it. Coding is done, and it provided game instruction as I wanted. Let's try this game. That is just amazing. Look how cool this game is. I just used a single prompt, nothing else. I will definitely give a huge pass for this prompt. Now, I want to hear from you. What do you think about DeepSeek V30324? Is it a game changer, or does it still have room to grow? Drop a comment below, and let's get the discussion going. Thank you for watching, and if you found this breakdown useful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on the latest AI updates.